This is your math gal, Julie Harland. Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com, where all of my videos are organized by topic. This is part two of degree measures of angles, and we're going to be talking about positive and negative angles, quadrantal angles, and some commonly used angles. So, the degree measure of an angle is positive if its rotation is counterclockwise and vice versa. So if you have a positive angle, like 30 degrees, you have a counterclockwise arrow here. Okay, and if you have a counterclockwise arrow, then we're talking about a positive angle. The degree measure of an angle is negative if its rotation, this little arrow here, is in the clockwise direction, and vice versa. So if you see negative 45 degrees, you've got to make sure you're going in this clockwise direction, okay? So that's all there is to whether it's positive or negative. Okay, given that, let's draw an angle of 120 degrees and negative 90 degrees. All right, let's do 120 degrees first. So the way I think about this is 120 is 90 plus 30 more. So if I think of my x and y axis here, which is easiest for me to do, I think, well, if I go 90 degrees, I'm about up to here, but I got to go 30 more degrees. So that means, so here I'm starting, and how about I end about right here? Okay, now I'm just sketching these. When I say draw it, it's not exact. We'd have to get out a protractor, but it's in the positive direction, so I went up here 120 degrees. Now, if you could also just free draw something like this, okay? I didn't say you had to do it on the x and y axis. That just helps me kind of measure that 90 degrees plus 30 degrees more. Right, how about negative 90 degrees? All right, so again, let's go ahead and think about what it looks like if we're looking at our x and y axis. And let's say if we're starting here, right, we have our initial start here, and then we're going in the negative direction, so we're going down, right? And we're gonna go down 90 degrees, that's a fourth of the way, and that would be negative 90 degrees. So, remember, when it's a 90 degree angle, you could square it off with a little square. Okay. Another way to draw it is just over on the side. You're showing that it's negative 90 by drawing that arrow. That's how you could tell. Now, if an angle is in standard position, like we did on the previous page, where we put the initial side right on the x-axis, the right side of the x-axis, right? We say it, the angle, lies in the quadrant where its terminal side lies. All right, so what am I saying? All we do is we look at where the terminal side of an angle lies, and we say, oh, that angle is in that quadrant. So let's look back. So if I look at 120 degrees here in this position, right, where does its terminal side end? So for 120 degrees, we see the terminal side of 120 degrees ends in quadrant. Okay, now let's see. Do you remember where the quadrants are? Remember, if you've got your quadrants, that you have to know is 1, 2, 3, and 4. And here it is up here in quadrant 2. So the terminal side of 120 degrees, you know, that angle, ends in quadrant 2. I'm sorry, in quadrant 2. So instead of saying all that, we just say 120 degrees is in quadrant 2. Okay, or lies in quadrant 2. So we say 120 degrees lies in quadrant two. So you're really looking at the terminal side, but we don't write all that out. Okay? Same thing if we want to figure it out for negative 90 degrees. All right, so the terminal side in 90, negative 90 degrees, it's not in a quadrant. It's right here on the y-axis. So the terminal side of 90 is on the y-axis, right? So that means negative 90 is a quadrantal angle. I'm not sure I had said that yet, but here it is. I think I quit ahead of time. If its terminal side is on the x or y axis, it's called a quadrantal angle. So 270 degrees is a quadrantal angle as shown because just like negative 90 degrees, its terminal side, right? There's its terminal side right there. The terminal side is right on the y axis. This would also be true of a 180 degree angle because its terminal side is right on the x-axis. All right, now when you're learning trig, there's some angles that come up over and over again, and those are multiples of 30 degrees and 45 degrees. And so I've put some angles, all those angles that are multiples of 30 degrees and 45 degrees that happen to be in between 0 and 360 degrees. So I've only got positive angles here. And so if you could see the 30 degree angles here, like every 30 degrees, 30, 60, 90, 120, 150, 180, 210, 240, etc. And then the 45 degree angle, that's halfway in between 90. So those are the ones right through the center. I did it with a green color. 45, 90, 135, 180, 225, 270, 315. And if I went one more, it would be a 180. Notice I have this negative 30 degrees here. I just want to have you notice something. If I did draw a negative angle, negative 30 degrees, it ends up being the same place where 330 degrees is. So you can see I could have drawn a lot more in here, right? It goes on forever. So I would start repeating myself at some point. So it would be good for you to be able to reproduce this figure on your own. So you might want to try that. And notice, like, you know, this is just a sketch. These aren't exact. My lines don't even look like real lines. I'm freehand drawing it. But so this is 30 degrees, and it's 15 degrees here and 15 degrees here, right? From 30 to 45 and from 45 to 60. So these are kind of close together, and you got 30 degrees again. Then you got between 90 and 120, that's 30, and then 15 and 15, and then 30 again. So there's kind of this space here. Okay? And when you look at this, you can see that 30 degrees, 45 degrees, and 60 degrees, they all lie in quadrant 1, whereas 120 degrees, 135 degrees, and 150 degrees all lie in quadrant 2, etc. And the quadrantal angles you can see here are 0 degrees, 90 degrees, 180 degrees, and 270 degrees. Okay, so this is what we're going to be working with a lot. And we'll be doing negative angles as well, so multiples of the of these angles, you know, because I only drew the ones in between 0 and 360. Like you could have 30 times, you know, let's say 20, that would be 600 degrees. That's going to be somewhere in here as well, right, if I drew all of the multiples of 30. I just stopped at 330 degrees. Let's go back to the beginning. So going back one page at a time here, we decided that 270 degrees was a quadrantal angle. When we did these, we wrote that 120 degrees lies in quadrant 2 and that 90 degrees is a quadrantal angle. Okay, so let me just sort of highlight that. We came up with this information. And then if I go back once more, let's just also go ahead and do these. Where does 30 degrees lie? What quadrant? Well, it's over here in quadrant one. And what about this negative 45 degrees? Where does it lie? That's quadrant four. Okay, so that's all there is to it. This is your math gal, Julie Harland. Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com, where all of my videos are organized by topic.